You know, as long as I've known him, everything works for him. There's nothing he can't handle. I can't handle anything. School, parents, future. Ferris can do anything.
Live from Chicago, America's number one dance show, Dance TV, is on the air.
Yep. I said it before and I'll say it again. Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
Oh my God! So many films filmed in Chicago. If you go back to the '40s, you got a movie that was produced in Hollywood by a major studio, but it was filmed almost entirely on location in Chicago. Call North Side 777 with James Stewart, and that was one of the early examples of a true crime story financed and distributed by a major studio that actually filmed on location here. And it's a great look at post-World War II Chicago. If you haven't seen that film, it's just really worth checking out just for the locations. Because so much of that city that we see in that movie is now gone. There was a late silent era gangster film called Underworld about a kind of an Al Capone type bootlegger. And that was kind of loosely rewritten and made much more famous a few years later in the early sound era as Scarface, the first Scarface, long before Pacino, you know, did his version down in Miami, right? This was Scarface.
Hey guys,
come on, man, that's not gonna work. You can't do it that way, I'm telling you. You know how you pick up chicks in this country?
What the fuck was that? What you just did?
That's it. That's what you do.
That is disgusting.
Watch.
Ooh, look at that fucking thing. That looks like a lizard. Like a bug coming out of your mouth. Oh, look at that. Hey! Yo!
You're sick!
You see what happened here?
Even if they never actually spent 1 second shooting in Chicago, that was to millions of moviegoers, that was the image of Chicago. You know, the Tommy gun, the bootlegging. We've got a pretty healthy amount of feature film and television activity here because we've got...
We'd like to play a little tune for you. It's one of my personal favorites. And I'd like to dedicate it to a young man who doesn't think he's seen anything good today. Cameron Fry, this one's for you.
Not ashamed.